For this video, we're going to talk about how to install a window and how to pre-flash and post-flash for the install of the window. Here you can see the students are installing the sill flashing. That's the first piece that goes on after you install your waterproofing, such as in this case, your Tyvek house wrap. So making vertical cuts, you can see that they're gonna flap the piece down onto the sill. That's what protects the sill for any moisture underneath your window. This piece of sill flashing is the first of a two-step method. The first, make these cuts. The second, you can either do a long horizontal piece, or in like these students are doing, is separate individual pieces. Got to have it in such a way that it rolls up the sill and a little bit, at least 3 to 6 inches on the sides. The next cut of what these apprentices are going to make is directly out towards you. That when making this cut though, make sure you're not going tight into the corner. You need to be at least 1/4 inch out, so that when you do slice it, you stretch those corners. You're trying to stretch it so it can cover that inside, outside corner. You should be able to see here, as I zoom in, the corner on the right was trimmed a little bit too far. So it reveals a little pinhole, and that's the weak point of this system. So by doing this next step, it's called a bow tie, you're stretching that piece into that corner and causing to fill that, that weak point, a bow tie. If you think ahead, this bow tie should be installed underneath that corner piece. But if for some reason you make a mistake like this right here, the fix for it is not just caulking. You gotta install another piece of flashing like this, in this example, the bow tie. There are several other products that can be used instead of this system, but for us, for learning purposes, learning details, this is what we're using. Other systems you can stretch up in one single piece up the sides. Here's another product that are all compatible with the Tyvek system. That's an important step, is making sure your products are compatible with the vapor barriers that weather barriers that you're using.
We cut this one straight down, so now we're going to cut this one out.
Yeah,
and we're going to keep about 1/4 inch out.
There you go. Why 1/4 inch out?
Because if you don't, you'll be left with a little hole right there. So you stretch it kind of like that. And then it covers that little point right there, that hole.
All right, well, what happens if you messed up and you got a little hole right here?
A bow tie?
A bow tie, okay. Can you show me that?
Yeah.
How do you do that? Very nice. So how he stretched it right here, so it covers that corner real good.
And
cut another one?
Yeah, sure.
So hold that up to your neck. Yeah, bow tie, look at that.
That's funny.
So ideally, you planned ahead. You have your seal wrap, then your bow tie, and this piece over top of it. That way we don't have this piece right here.
Oh, okay.
So water could come down here or here, and if there's a horizontal seam, it's gonna want to try to go in.
Oh, okay.
So if this piece is under that piece, everything shingles correctly.
Oh, okay. So okay. Do this before that.
Yes.
That makes sense. Okay.
At this point, you're now ready to install your window. Make sure you're double checking the dimensions of your window and double checking your rough opening in case you have to do any adjustments or reframing. You should have at least a quarter inch all the way around your window so that you can shim your window nice and plumb, level.
Put your level on there. That look?
That looks good.
I think it needs to go up just a teeny tiny bit more. There you go. That's probably perfect. Don't do that. Then it's going to rest on top of the head of that screw unless you got flat nails. It's okay if you can just put the window right on top of it. You don't have to fasten those down.
Okay.
Out towards this outer edge. Window in. Well, forgetting something.
What?
You gotta caulk it.
Oh.
There we go. There we go.
For class purposes, we're gonna use a pin just to indicate that they're putting caulking on the sides and the head. Do not, like he was about to do not put caulking on that bottom. You gotta have somewhere for that water to drain out. Caulk goes on the sides, the head, and right down in that corner that it could be a vulnerable corner. Puts quite a bit of caulk right down in those corners, just like you just did. Okay, the head goes right on the wood, and double check and triple check, taking a clean rag with mineral spirits, and make sure you're cleaning that window nice and good. Even a brand new window from the factory is gonna have oils on it. Gotta clean that very well with mineral spirits or denatured alcohol, so you have a good bond. Now, installing the window, try to put the bottom in first, resting it on top of the shims, and then tipping the top in place. That way it doesn't push the caulking around or the shims. This group did the reverse order. Now, after that's in place, it's time to go inside, double check that your window is centered. So here it needs to go a little bit to the left, centering that into the opening. That way sheetrock and your reveal matches on both sides. After it's centered, it's time to get the level, and again, make sure your window is nice and plumb. We checked the sill was level, now we're checking to see if the window is plumb. Hold that level up and try your best to make it perfect. Perfectly centered in between the lines like it is there. Here now, the fur fasteners, they're gonna use a truss head screw on the top, bottom of the sides, and the same on each side, filling each hole, slotted hole, on each side of the window. The bottom does not get screwed. Reason being, you'll be penetrating that sill. Even though it is a self-healing membrane, it's best not to fasten it. Your trim and your siding will be holding that bottom in place. The top, best method for screwing the top of the window is using a fender washer and a screw, holding the screw above the flange at least a quarter inch to allow for shrinkage of the wood and compressing of the other floors.
So you're gonna want an 1/8 inch gap here, so when your trim butts up against it, you have room for caulking.
Okay.
All right.
Underneath your metal flashing, you have a layer of peel and stick self-healing membrane. On top of that metal flashing, you have another piece that goes over top of it. This is an important step. Once that's complete, flap down your Tyvek or your WRB, put a diagonal flashing or tape, Tyvek tape, and that completes the window install and waterproofing for the window. Done right, you seal up the house and you should have no issues or damages later.